My name is Félix Buendía. I'm coming from Universitat Politécnica de Valencia. I'm a lecturer in a computer engineering department. And the purpose of this presentation is to show a preliminary work about the design of an annotation tool in the context of a project, a research project. We are collaborating with the Universidad Complutense de Madrid, José Luis Antonio, in the context of the project, Red Air and Human Repositories for Education with Dynamic Interoperability in the Humanities. And the relationship is, because we think it's one of the goals of the project, is to design to obtain an annotation tool for the annotation of the resources, the learning objects stored in this kind of repositories. Then that is the main issue, but let me start by defining some previous concept about the annotation. Very simple concept, because I guess that everybody knows about the meaning of annotating as the process of adding notes. As for example, in this image, in the old times, people used to write annotations and written annotations in the margin or in text. Today, we have technologies, very advanced technologies, to improve this process of annotation. And the matter, or the main question is, why should learning resources, for example, in the context of a repository, should be annotated? That is the main question. Then, in our work, we try to analyze different technologies existing in the world, in the technological market, in order to annotate. Mainly for collaboration, mainly in the context of web-based applications. And we also need to justify, or because as I said before, that is a preliminary work, we're trying to justify the need to design this kind of annotation tools, and that is the reason for this work. Then the proposal I have elaborated is the process of design within the elaboration or together with the elaboration of a small prototype of annotation tool, but remarking two main aspects that are the process of designing the application from the requirements gathered at the beginning in contact with the responsible for the project, for the research project, to a prototype. To the development of till the development of a prototype, in order to test how this process, design process, can be checked or can be corrected. And another important principle, another important issue is the separation of concern, in order to split the different stages in the design. Then we have reviewed several references about the use of annotation in the educational context, but mainly in collaborative tasks. That is a very specific context in the annotation. Because we believe that in learning, one of the aspects that improve learning aspects is the collaboration among students or even among tutors, students. This type of interaction, this type of collaboration, we think it's very positive for the process of learning, for the process of instruction to the students. And one of the first references is from Bateman, is the system OATS, Open Annotational Tagging System. We think tagging is a concept parallel to annotation, because this concept tries to introduce keywords or tags in order to label some content, some learning resources. One of the first references, and there are several works I have gathered or collected some works, including one that was developed by authors or by colleagues in the same project. But in general, there are annotation tools that are generally standalone tools, nor web-based, except for example, AdNote, that is an electronic node or electronic tool based on Google, the API from Google to work to all of the sharing of annotation. Okay, after reviewing the different tools, kind of tools and technologies, you said, we try to propose a process, design process for this kind of annotation tools. And the first aspect we realized was to separate or to split according to the separation of concept principle, to separate the different areas, different requirements for each area in the presentation aspect, business logic, and persistence. They are very generic. One of the reviews I received for the paper, they complain about these requirements are not very specific. But my purpose, my aim is to define general areas to classify the possible requirements. And these requirements come from, for example, the location of the nodes. That is important because many times it's very difficult to focus where the annotation is put, is not displayed but introduced. It's one of the critical points in the annotation. Or the tidy nodes, or there are several areas and we try to classify the different requirements. And once the main requirements are gathered, the next step consists in designing the different aspects of the annotation tool, thinking not only in a standalone tool, that is a typical, but also in a tool that can be transversal, that can be used with repository, with external repository. That was one of the main concerns, because we developed a prototype, a standalone tool, but it's not useful if you try to annotate external resources. And this, in this case, we try to solve some aspect about the user interface. In this case, coming from the Scala project, a project that is referenced in the bibliography of the paper, and the use of mockup or sketch to represent, that is a standalone, to represent different annotation tools, different mechanisms to annotate, the different, for example, colors used to display the kind of annotations, the text, the document text, the annotation text associated to this document, this kind of characteristics need to be defined before we implement it, or try to implement the tool. The second tier, after the user interface, is dealing with the business process, the business logic layer. In this case, I have selected another one, Zendesk annotation architecture, that is based in a clear server architecture that is very typical in annotation tools. And in this case, the annotation processes are based on defining workflows and rules that control these workflows, in order to separate the logic of this process that control the annotation. For example, the handlers in the client side to control what kind of objects or what kind of information in this object, in this learning object, image, text, video, every multimedia resource can be annotated. And then we need handlers to select or to obtain information to be annotated. And also there are other handlers, for example, for assigning semantic information to the kind of annotation. This is in the client side and in the service side, but this is only an example of architecture. We have the managers. The managers using APIs that receive the information from the controllers in order, for example, to storage or to store the annotation or the people who are authorized to annotate a document. And finally, the last tier is the persistence. It's about the storage model. And again, I have selected the PAMS annotation management, where this is an entity relationship or relation diagram to represent a very simple model where we have six main entities and relationships. between association, for example, between users and annotators of it. That is only a model, but we need a model in order to design the annotation tool, because we don't know exactly how this tool will be implemented. After the proposal of the design process, with the help of a student that developed last year his project, his final project, he developed it using different technologies, a prototype, a standalone prototype where the document has to be uploaded to the server, and then he prepared using jQuery and, for example, Bootstrap, you know, for developing web applications. He developed a web application to annotate. This is the first screen, a screenshot, but the main question is, I don't know if the resolution is enough, but the main question is how to locate the object to be annotated, for example, annotations. There is the text to be annotated, highlighted portion of the text, chunks of the text that are annotated, and finally we have in the right side about the list of annotation. There is a couple, because you have to control the different users, different groups. There are several processes, several business or logic processes to manage all the annotation. But this is the interface, the presentation offered to the user. The next aspect about the how to have a prototype to implement this, the business tire with the project was later on the use of JavaScript called Annotator ES of JavaScript, based on plugins that can manage the annotation story or the access to the different users, and the use of a CLS framework in order to control the client server architecture using IaaS requests and so on. That's an example. And the last part is based on the entire is based on the use of the JSON. It's a very popular format for annotated for managing the annotation. Then we have annotator. The library provides a format based on this JSON annotation to record, to store the annotation. But this can be edited, or can be updated or changed, and it's perfect. And another, finally, in the case study, we try to, but this is not in our project, but for us it was very important to access the annotation, because in the current prototype it's not possible. This screenshot is from a tool, Hypothesis, that is based on the same library, Annotator.js. But the matter is how to recover, how to retrieve the information. JSON format is the same. How to retrieve externally in order to analyze, for example, the interaction, the collaboration between or among the different users for the annotation tool. For the conclusion, I will remark that there is a high number of design issues involved in the development of annotation tool. We are trying to classify in order to simplify to help to the design, to the development, design, elaboration of the annotation tool. We are trying to classify the different types, the different components of the application, and separate in this component. That is, we think, is very important. And this process led us to build, as a case study, a small prototype based on JavaScript, as for mentioned. And the challenge now is how to apply in the context of the Red Air human project, how to implement an annotation tool that can be used with external repositories and test it. And that is the end of my presentation.